actually. I can separate my presentation in three parts. The first part deals with XPL versioning as a task. The second one, how this task can be integrated in the change management process. And the third one is the geeky part with a short overview about the last dimensional modules that were published by the versioning working group dealing with dimensional versioning, especially. So I started with the versioning as a task. What is a task? A task is, from an external point of view, something that is related with a specific purpose. It's being contacted by an object of task by a specific action. It has a precondition before this task starts and a condition after the execution of this task. It has goals and objectives that should be reached after the task, and we can identify previous events and also post events that are reached, and they build up the results of execution. From an internal point of view of a task, we have something like a solution process, how this task can be conducted. And this helps out to identify actions that can be automated. From the XPL versioning point of view, the task is the versioning of two taxonomy versions in compliance with the XPL versioning specification. It can be based on two consecutive versions. As usual, you have a specific version, you have a next version on these taxonomies, or you can use it on two variants of the same base taxonomy. For example, we in CoREP, as I'm co-coordinating the European Eurofiling project, we have 10 to 14 variants of the CoREP taxonomy currently dealing with national discretions, and with the help of versioning, we could identify similarities. Or we can use versioning on two different taxonomies that may be related. For example, US GAAP with IFRS or whatever. So we could build up the equalities between these taxonomies. The object of task is the versioning report itself. It should present a chronicle of changes in the course of time, and it should document why and by whom and when the change was made. We have the previous events. What leads us to versioning? Normally we have contextual demands. For example, we have new accounting standards, new amendments on regulatory rules. We have technical adaptations. We want to introduce a formula link base in our taxonomy. We have bug fixes, build on typos, whatever. They should be also fixed in the new version. And the post events? Yes, certainly. This should be a complete versioning report for our users. For example, for taxonomies, reviewers that ensure that the quality of our taxonomy is okay. For instance, creators, for example, in our case, banks who have to file into banking supervisors. We have instance receivers like we could use also the report, versioning report for our own to amend our mapping processes. We have the taxonomy extenders, if there are some, for example, for the IFRS taxonomy. For the CoREP taxonomy, there won't be any extension special in the upcoming years. And also for the taxonomy publishers, they are also interested. What is inside this new version now? Which changes have been incorporated? What is the goal of XPL versioning? The goal is to have a version report that fulfills all our requirements. These requirements were collected in our versioning working group, and they are now represented in the versioning requirements document. We want to have the documentation of all changes and also the equalities between two taxonomy versions. We want to capture all reasons why changes have been made. We want a specification for the scope, so we want, as a project manager, say, these versions should be included in our version report, but those that are not so interesting for our clients, maybe these are changes on a base taxonomy which we have incorporated, for example, the IFRS taxonomy, but our wants to deal only with our own changes. And we want a definition of the structure and the design, so we want to have automated processes based on this versioning report, and it should be also human readable. This is very interesting for the reviewers. We want to have a report that can be reviewed by business users that have these contextual demands on these versioning reports. We have also objectives we have to deal with. We want to increase the acceptance of our taxonomy. We as regulators, we have not a big problem. You can say you have to use this taxonomy, but for the case of IFRS, it's very interesting to have the to increase the acceptance. So with the versioning report, changes are documented, then a lot more information is given than before, and it could say, okay, this is a good quality, we can accept a taxonomy that helps us to integrate it in our systems to help us automate processes. It should be also provide benefits for our users by providing a good quality of the information included. It should have a sufficient coverage, where it says that project manager, I have only to deal with a small amount of changes and I left out the main part, then it is not a good quality and it's not sufficient coverage. It should also provide sufficient information. So maybe some are interested why the change has been made. If there's just this change has been made, then maybe it's not sufficient for our business users. We want to we want that the versioning report supports the different versioning modules. So we have three or four different. I go to the next models in a due time. And if we support more modules, then more of our taxonomy requirements are fulfilled. We want to raise the effectiveness of automated processes on instance mappings, and we want to increase the efficiency of processes based on these changes. And then we can look at the internal view on the task. This is our solution process. It's being conducted by a task actor to reach the goal. And it is initiated by a previous event, and post events mark the finalization. And actions, which can be described in a functional way, as we do with our versioning report, we describe exactly which changes have been made, and this enables us to automate processes. What is the solution process of experimental versioning? Okay, we do not define any solution process. This has to be done by our software vendors. So we expect that the software vendors incorporate our demands on experimental versioning in their software, because we really demand on these preconditions. What we provide is a set of XML schemas that the versioning report has to follow. And we assume that these changes on taxonomies are detected by automated processes. For example, if we have a taxonomy editor that can incorporate two taxonomy versions, and these taxonomy editors should detect all the changes being done from one to the other version. In this case, this is the task actor as a machine. We have also specific requirements in our requirement document that has to be fulfilled by the versioning software. We won't have a capture of documentation during the editing process. So if a taxonomy editor gets the version, he changes something, then he should be able to also document changes directly. And also he should be able to stop working at one day and continue working on another day. We want to have a human-readable versioning report to visualize our changes for business users, for other reviewers, so that we can see that the changes have been made according to our requirements. And we want to have a documentation of these changes in a semi-automated process. So the task actor is a human supported by a machine. For example, I am as a taxonomy editor, typing in a taxonomy editing software and describe what I have been done. Okay, now I came to the how this task can be integrated in our change management process. Everything changes and nothing remains still was said by Plato and being interpreted by Heraclit. So what we have to deal with is we have to deal with changes regularly, on a regular basis. It's predictable. We have in every year or every 2 years, we have changes. according to contextual demands, technical adaptations, and so on. These are mostly functional changes, and they have a high impact. From our point of view, for your filing, when we change our taxonomies, it has impact on 27 national central banks. It has impact on 8,000 different institutions in Europe. And we have to fulfill constraints, for example, cost and time constraints. The changes have to be done in a specific point of time, and such costs should not be too high. If you know, our project doesn't deal with a lot of money. Change management from a project point of view. You can see change management from an economic point of view. This is how the company is changing and how can I deal with these changes. But now I point on this project point of view and like to explain the change management on this specific change management. This defines how to deal with requests for changes in an XBR project, so the ones you are dealing with, some of our people, for example. It aims to specify an efficient standard and standardized project process for this handling of changes. And we want to provide a very good quality for our taxonomy. And we want to document all these processes for repetition of these changes, because we have to do it yearly or every 2 years. We want to also define guidelines to limit the risk of each change management. And we want to have that our deadlines are reached. And how these processes can be seen. So we start with the entry of a change request. We can define or we can separate three different categories of changes. We have corrective changes, mostly based on errors and typos. We have adaptive changes based on contextual changes and adaptations to new specifications in XBR, for example, formula. We have exceptional changes, so these are changes with a high priority and they have to be done in due time. The next step, when we receive these requests for changes, we have to verify if these changes are really needed, if they have possible benefits for us, and...
doing things.
Okay, thank you. And if we have bigger changes, maybe changes on the taxonomy architecture itself, we should make an impact analysis. For example, how much costs are involved with these change requests? How much time do we need to implement these changes? And so on. So this should be a very deeply verified and afterwards, after this improvement, accepted or not by the project team, by a project responsible person, whoever, who is responsible for this change management. In this planning phase, we also have to deal with the versioning identification. The version is a specific point or a specific state of a changing data object, in this case our taxonomy, and it is a result of an update. In the Eurofiling project, we use a three-level numbering system. You could also use a two-level one or whatever. But this one, I think, is quite okay because it shows non-functional changes on the third level of this identification numbering, minor functional changes which have influence on the instance creation on the second level, and the first level is showing the new release, for example, when we have substantial changes, like we have in 2012, we changed to a harmonized taxonomy in CoRab, and then we say, okay, this is a major release, a major change which we identify with a new release. We have to also think about our versioning structure. For example, we could have a linear sequences of versions if we do not need any nesting sequences. In the beginning, we had also nested structures of versionings, and we had variants on FinRep with a transformation process hint to the dimensional taxonomy we have now, only linear sequences of taxonomies. But you have to decide about this and search for an appropriate numbering system. Yeah, you have to deal with the frequency. Regularly you have a versioning every year, every 2 years, whatever, to a fixed time normally. So you have yearly adoption to accounting standards, regulations, and so on. And there are included corrective as well as adaptive changes. And you have on-demand versioning. For example, when we find a bug in the early stage of a taxonomy, we have to adapt this change on the taxonomy and publish this taxonomy as soon as possible. And these are exceptional changes with which we have to deal with and which need maybe a very short change management process with clear defined steps. We have also to deal in our planning phase with the composition of our project team. Do we have enough resources to implement the changes? We need to have a milestone planning and a detailed planning also of all the activities which are related with these changes. We have then to deal with the implementation and test phase. The changes have to be done into the taxonomies according to our requirements and specifications. So all the requirements that were accepted are now listed in a specification, and this has to be processed by a taxonomy editor. And now we can see which tools could be optimize our processes. So we can identify some actions that can be supported with an automation process. For example, the NixBRL repository could help us storage and make a version control on a technical versioning basis. We have also a taxonomy editor. It would be helpful if you could support us with XBRL versioning because it's needed that we implement the documentation directly within the editing process. We need also a taxonomy validator to validate if our taxonomy is after the change is still valid. And also a taxonomy viewer for the first review process by the editing author. And this process can be finalized by evaluation and in finalization phase. So we have to be sure that the quality is assured via manual and automated tests, internal technical reviews, so and internal business reviews, external quality review team. This is being done by the AFS team, and I think this is very good. Possibility to have a review on a small amount of experts, having a deep review on this taxonomy and say, okay, before you publish it, we have these and these points identified that should be changed before the publication. We could also get in contact directly with some users to get a pre-feedback before publication. And also you can start an open review period before you finalize your version and publish the last final and accepted one. Yes, this phase can be supported by a human readable versioning report and by comprehensive information included for early adopters of the taxonomy. Finally, you can publish your new taxonomy with the corresponding XBRL versioning report and other useful documentation. So I think the XBRL versioning is a missing link in this change management process. Because the quality of our products, in this case the taxonomies, depend on good managed processes. They should be proven and documented and enable us to meet the cost and time constraints. And the identification of these functional tasks opens the possibilities of automation. If we do not have a deep view and are not aware about these processes, we are not able to improve our processes. And with the help of XBRL versioning, we are able to improve an automation part. For example, typing out all of the changes done on a paper or on an HTML document is a very hard work, and It can be done only by small changes, but not by a lot of changes that are being done in the taxonomy version. And we can also reach a higher maturity level on these processes. You see here a list of a hierarchy of processes, maturity levels. For example, when you're in the initial phase, okay, you started with the XBL project, you have unpredictable process, it's poorly controlled and reactive. You can react very, very quick, but it's not really controlled. The next step on this ladder is managed processes. Okay, you introduced your projects to deal with changes. You can repeat these projects successfully. Another step above is the defined and managed processes. Sorry. And these are, you already defined standard processes on changes. And you can continue an improvement process. Qualitatively managed processes are projects that can be measured and controlled. You have statistics, heuristics, and so on to see if your processes are really good. And the optimized processes dealing just with the improvement of these processes. So these are the very high level that should be reached, I think, also in our XBL projects. Okay, finally, before you go and finalize, I think this is already done. Okay, XBL versioning can support you with the gathering of the technical changes between these two taxonomy versions. It can provide essential information for the users and enables us to automate your processes, your own change processes. It gives detailed information about for the business reviews. It provides possibility to compare taxonomies with similar scopes. It increases the quality of your taxonomy and may also increase the acceptance of these taxonomies and widen the extent of your participants. The main project supporting right now is the XBL versioning as listed here. I'm not sure if the list is really fine, are the SPR Australia project, the Belgian XBL projects, IFRS XBL team, and the Eurofiling project. As far as I know, maybe SPR Netherlands also supporting us. I think this is the only standard to enable us to optimize our change processes on XBL taxonomies. Now I come to the third part on XBL versioning. Going a bit deeper into the relationship set and the instance aspect module. We have currently three different modules in XBL international specifications as candidate recommendations. They are dealing all with XBL 2.1. What's missing for us and for all projects that are dealing with dimensions is the relationship set module and the instance aspect model. They are still in public working draft. The instance aspect model is based on the module space and concept based. It includes support for multidimensional taxonomies and it focuses on changes that have impact on the instance structure itself. Its aim is to raise efficiency and effectiveness for handling changes on XBL instances, should provide a functional description of these changes and enable automated processes. Here you see some aspects identified on effect. We have the concept aspect, the name of the concept. We have the unit aspect, the entity identifier aspect, the period aspect, and the explicit dimension aspect. This is not a complete list of all aspects, for example, type dimension aspects are also included. And here I have an example. We have a from taxonomy that have a primary item sales and a dimensional item referring to this primary with Czechoslovakia. As these countries have been separated, we have a new model for in our instance. A primary can now combine with Czech Republic and Slovakia. So the explicit dimension aspect has been changed so from Czech Slovakia to Czech Republic or Slovakia that can be used now in our instance. The relationship site module also is based on the module-based and concept-based, includes also support for multidimensional taxonomies, and it focuses on changes on the taxonomy structure. So this is really relevant for taxonomy maintainers. They get aware about the changes being done in the taxonomy itself, not the instance related. It could have changes, major changes on the taxonomy, for example, a new taxonomy structure dealing with a lot of changes on hypercubes, but it's not related to our instance. The aim is to handle changes based on expert taxonomies, provide functional description as well as the instance aspect module, and to increase the possibilities of automated processes. Here we see a small change being done on a taxonomy. For example, an hypercube was linked to the primary item I3, and it's now moved to the primary item I1 to I3 in the next taxonomy. It's all done on the extended link rule Z1. This can be seen in our versioning report that the relationship Z has been changed from the link rule Z1 in the arc rule all to a relationship from HREF H1 to the primary item I3. Further dimensional changes are here also applied, for example, context changes. If we move from segment to scenario, these are built up in these relationship set models. We can identify changes on the closed attribute or changes on the usable attribute. So we must combine both of these modules to reach the full support for versioning on dimensions. For example, to enable a complete mapping automation process, we have to get into both models and deal with both models. The conclusions for our Eurofiling project, which I'm a member, yes, we needed essentially to support our banking supervisors, to support our banks and financial institutions in Europe. Yes, we have data points, 20,000 and more, alone in CoREP. We also provide FinWeb taxonomies, and a manual detection of changes is almost impossible. So if you have just 3 or 4, this might be possible, but for big expert projects, it's not longer at all. Yes, we also are dealing now with the use of dimension a lot more than before, and we have about 50 to 60 or more dimensions by reduction of the primary items. So we really need the dimensional support for versioning. Yeah, and we see it as essential to increase the acceptance of our taxonomy, to ensure that we have a good quality, and to reach a higher maturity of our own processes. And we want to improve the quality of our taxonomy. We can provide a versioning report when our taxonomy is much more of a quality, because we have much more information useful for our clients. Thank you very much for your attention.